Hi, welcome to the RV Corral website. My name is Jim Beckler. I want to show you a brand new motorhome. We just arrived here on our lot. This is a 2020 model. It's a Tiffin motorhome. You may be familiar with Tiffin Manufacturing. They've been around since 1972, been building motorhomes for generations. And in fact, it's speaking of generations, it's a family-run business, and they do have a founding father still involved in the business, and his sons and grandsons. So it's quite the operation they have. Nice thing about having a family-run business is they're very hands-on in their approach to customer service. You've probably already heard about Tiffin, or maybe you have one now. You're just thinking about upgrading, getting a newer coach. This is a 34PA is the model number. Again, 2020. For starters, I want to mention it's built on a Ford chassis. It's a 26,000 pound chassis. So it's one of the bigger chassis that you can get in a gas coach powered by a Triton V10. So you're going to have a lot of power, good performance. The advantage with having a little heavier chassis is it's going to roll better. You know, the heavier chassis tend to have a little bit less steering issues. This one's also equipped with Sumo springs, so you'll really like the way this coach drives. You're going to have a really good experience with this, and the floor plan's awesome. It's a four slide out unit. We'll see once we go inside how really user friendly the layout is inside. Very good finish on their paint process. This is a full body paint. They call this Rocky Mountain Brown. Has some more of the earth tones in it. They put at least, this coach has about four coats of paint on it, plus about at least two to four coats of clear coat on it. So the process is done very well, so you're going to have a motorhome that's going to look good over a long period of time. You're not going to have issues with fading and the paint going bad on you. 22 and a half inch tires, again, that's an advantage because you do have better contact to the ground. Bigger tires are going to roll better. Feel a little bit more like a heavier motorhome, which basically it is. See down the side here, we've got the two slide outs on this side. There's going to be two on the other side also. Nice big awning. Patio awning comes out. It's electric. Push button. Does have, for your entertainment, outside TV. Sound bar already on board. You might want to sit out here and pull that awning out, take in a movie, or maybe you're tailgating, watching your favorite team play. Good pass-through storage. Actually, almost all these compartments go all the way across on the top side. For a gasoline-powered coach, you know, having the engine up front and the drive axle running through, they utilize the space really well. Here's your central back and all the apparatus that goes with it. Notice how the cargo doors swing out like a car door. There's your fresh water tank. I like the fact they put the indicators on the outside instead of the inside of the tank. The nice thing about that is it's not really as critical on a fresh water tank, which we're looking at here, as it is like on your black tank. But if you have these indicators on the inside of the tank, well, you know what I'm saying. You've maybe owned a motorhome before. You know that stuff gets hung up on these little indicators inside of there, maybe toilet paper or whatever, and next thing you know, you're getting misreading. So having them on the outside eliminates a lot of that problem. All these cargo doors are done in-house because Tiffin is a vertically integrated company. They manufacture a lot of what they put in their motorhome themselves. These are fully insulated doors. There's a solid block foam insulation in between the two cargo skins. And that's, like I said, they swing out like a car door, shut like a car door. Good sized propane tank. Again, utilizing the storage up on top there, pass through, good place to throw your fishing poles. Again, more storage up here. I can access my these are your house batteries right here. Looks like you've got four house batteries in here. Easy access, like I say, that pulls out. You do have a ladder to get up on top. It is a one-piece fiberglass roof. It's molded already, so when they drop that roof on the motorhome and attach it to the sidewalls, it's already got that contour in place, so they're not putting a lot of pressure to meet the sidewalls. The advantage with that is you're going to have less problems. There's less stress in that area when you're going down the road. They actually reinforce the roof where it makes that corner too, where the fiberglass is going to be a lot thicker than it would be on the top. So you got fiberglass that comes across the top, which is a laminated roof, by the way, and it's insulated. But when it makes that corner, the fiberglass is a lot thicker. I had a chance to see that when I was at the factory a few years ago. Other side of the pass of the storage area back here, built-in hardwire surge protector. That'll protect you when you're maybe at a campground, if you happen to get a power surge or some kind of dirty power, as they say, your appliances aren't blowing up on you. This one does have a 2000 watt inverter, so it has an upgrade on the inverter. 50 amp power, got lots of power coming into your motorhome. This is about as close as you're going to get to a diesel motorhome as far as some of the features and the chassis, you know, still being a gas coach, of course, but heavier chassis, lots of upgrades, 7,000 watt on-end generator, gas-powered generator, alloy wheels, beautiful alloy wheels. Tiffin doesn't really crimp on their appointments on their coaches. Their coaches are very nicely equipped. Notice the wet bays, nice and clean, easy to navigate. Nothing's too difficult here to get to. Even your water pump's out front here. I can turn on my water pump from out here. I have a black tank flush, so I can clean out my black tank by putting some pressured water to that outside shower. Even have the whole house water filter, so all your water coming in is going to be filtered. Does have two furnaces, so you got a furnace for the rear and the furnace for the front. That way, with two zones, you're going to be able to regulate the temperature you maybe want in your bedroom area as opposed to the main living area. Notice all that storage. Again, for a gas coach, huge amount of storage. There's the hydraulics for the jacks and your slides, I believe, are hydraulic. Another storage compartment here. Side view cameras built into the mirrors, so you've got the ability to see what's going on in the side of your coach. So if you, for example, I'm going down the freeway and I want to change lanes, if I hit my turn signal, it's going to display that side of the coach, so the mirror will, or the camera will give me a good shot of what's going on that side of the coach, so before I actually make that change, I can make sure there's nobody back there where I can't see. Again, beautiful paint, fit and finish. Very comfortable motorhome. Great floor plan. Take a look inside. Hey, give me a call if you have questions. You know, there may be something that I'm going to overlook. You only spend so much time with me on this video. Give me a call on my direct line. It's 541-510-1017. Just come on inside. As I mentioned, 26,000 pound chassis is going to drive really nice. Good performance, good power, and very stable platform. You can see the dash is laid out nicely. Very user-friendly, more of an automotive style controls up front here. This one is built, does have the navigation built into it. Here's your backup. You have your backup camera. All that's in place here. Side view cameras. Even has a nice TV up front. Plenty of storage. I guess you can never have too much storage, right? It's nice to have places to put stuff when you're out on the road. Like I said, maybe you've been on the road doing some traveling, but you're just ready to do a little bit more and ready to upgrade. This would be a great floor plan. MCD shades are easy to operate. Both these front seats are going to spin around too, by the way, so you can utilize this as part of your furniture. They've made a change. Now, I mentioned this is a 2020, so they have made a few changes in this model. This is one of the things that they've done. Controls for your front slide outs are in a different place now. They have been on the seats, but they've been on the side. They put them here. And I like having the controls right on the seat themselves. That way you have first-hand view of where your slide out's at. So before that thing, you start pulling it in, you know exactly where you're at with your seat. And sometimes, you know, these seats can be back a little bit too far, and if you're not paying attention, or you're not in the right position to really see it, you can have a little collision with your slide out and your seat. So you don't want that to happen. That may have already, you may have already occurred at some point in your RV experience. That might be something that's happened to you, so you know what I'm saying. I can't say that I don't know from experience, because I've done the same myself. Notice all the storage, great cabinets. Tiffin does all their own cabinetry in-house. As I mentioned earlier, they're vertically integrated, so they're a true manufacturer. They even make their own windows, so these windows are manufactured at a Tiffin plant. So the advantage with having a vertically integrated company like this is the fact that, well, you, a couple of big factors. One is that you're going to have more consistent quality, because you have more control over the build process from everything. You know, obviously they don't build everything in this motorhome. The chassis they get from Ford, but as far as the house part goes, it's probably somewhere in the range of about 80% is built by Tiffin. So you have more consistent quality, more hands-on approach to how the, what's going into your motorhome. The other thing is, if you ever need parts, hey, they made it, it's easy to replace it. So many times they'll have the part somewhere on hand, because they've, you know, they do have, like when I was at the factory, I saw that they had a whole row of entry doors that go back for many years. So in case somebody needed an entry door, they just have some on hand. And even if they didn't have it, if they have the plans, if they manufactured and built it, they can replace it. Another TV here, all your Tiffin motorhomes are going to have four TVs. This is a really nice feature too. Now it's a fireplace slash heater. It's an electric heater, so you can use this to keep your coach heated up. If you're plugged in somewhere, running off your generator, you'd be able to run heat through that. Of course, you do have your main heat source is your propane furnace, which we already talked about the fact there's two of them, so you're going to have lots of ways to heat the coach. This one does have a heat pump in your front air conditioner. Also, it has dual airs. You don't see a return air hanging down from your ceiling. So everything is ducted throughout this coach. Even though you have two air conditioners up there, they don't blow the air in the more of a central location. So if you can take a look down the side of this, the top here, you can see there's a row all the way to the back, every so very close together of vents. So you've got some that are going to have air coming out, like this side has air that's blowing out this way. This side is has a filter in it. So in essence, what you've got, and they call this extraordinaire, this is something that Tiffin does in their motorhomes, that your air comes out this way and it's going to go up like this. So all throughout the coach, you've got a really steady flow of air. So you get a better airflow for one, and it's also a little quieter that way too. So you'll like the way that works. And this is something they use in all their motorhomes, whether you're spending $500,000 for their higher end coaches or their entry level coaches that are all the same, put the same thing in them. You know, they don't hold back on quality with the Tiffin motorhomes. That's one of the reasons why they've got some of the best-selling stuff out there. Not only do they have a great reputation for customer service, but they also offer a lot of value. This one has a nice dinette booth with storage underneath. You've got pull-out drawers down here, a couple of on both sides. Okay, you got seat belts down here too. So if you got somebody who wants to ride in the back here, you can get them buckled in. Nice little table. They use adjustable shelves on their storage cabinet. Makes it kind of nice. You can adjust those shelves the way you want. Notice the nice kitchen counter space in here. Residential style faucet with two large stainless steel sinks. And you have a three burner stovetop. You have a propane stove. Nice little setup. To have the covers over everything here so I can utilize all the space if I want to use it for a workspace. This is really nice too. I've got plug-ins on board that I can access by just, you know, pulling those up. USB ports, 110. I've got a 110 outlet here, here, and here. So you're not lacking for places to plug in some of your appliances. If anything, they tend to do overkill. Like really nice drawers, they put heavy duty door glides. That way you can put weight in these things because they're full extension drawers. You don't have to worry about them falling apart on you. And a really nice propane oven in this one. It's a glass front. A little different than what you've seen probably in some. Now this one's also equipped with a Truma hot water system, so you have tankless hot water. Then the adjustment right here is for your temperature setting, so you can adjust the amount of flow, how hot you want your water basically. Now, as long as you have water, access to water and propane, you're gonna have all the hot water you want. You don't have to worry about taking a short RV shower. Residential refrigerator, large capacity. Look at all those drawers. You got space to put lots of stuff. So if you're going to be taking a long trip, that is a big plus. Freezer with ice maker down below. Nice Whirlpool refrigerator. They tend to go with appliances that they research and find out which appliances have the least amount of problems. And so that's why they'll usually put that type of appliance. Some manufacturers go with, you know, whatever they get the cheapest bid from, and that's just not how they roll there at Tiffin. Or Bob Tiffin's philosophy is, if it's something he's gonna build and stand behind it, he's gonna wanna do it right. You've got access to your fuses and breakers and even a 110 outlet there. Multiplex wiring systems in this coach. So the advantage with that is, like you can see, I've got several controls here, and I'm going to show you something in just a second too, which basically I can access everything, pretty much everything in the coach. But with this multiplex system, you've got the wire loom, so you've got less wiring inside of the motorhome. It's easier to track if you do have an issue. You don't have to be trying to find where your wires are. So for example, if it's a issue with a lighting system or whatever the case may be, with that multiplex system, it's easier to track down. You're going to have less challenges with that. And if I can get this opened up here, there we go. It does have a lock on it. Nice pull-out pantry. Again, adjustable shelves. Now here's that panel I had mentioned that I can go to the house setting, which I'm at right now. I can access lighting. I can check my tank levels. Turn my water pump on. I can start my just give me the generator status. My two zones on the front and rear. You can notice it's a little warm today. Lighting, master switch here. I can turn everything off. I want to get back to that. I can do the same thing in my bedroom if I want to do that. The heating and air conditioning system I access here. I can adjust my temperature settings. So it looks like they're set at 69 right now. And as I mentioned earlier, the front does have a heat pump. So you can run your heat pump to produce heat for your front of your coach. These are my fans, so I can access those. I have a ceiling fan. Slide out control. So these are for three of these slide outs. And then this is my settings. So if I go to this, I can adjust my settings. So if I want to make adjustments, I can do that. Notice too, this year is they've expanded this little galley window. It's a little bit bigger than it's been in the past. This is actually a new feature. They came out with this last year. So we had a lot of people comment, it'd be nice to have a galley window. So they've given you that, and does have a shade, electric shade, to be able to close that off when you don't want it open. If we take a look inside the bathroom area, this does have a nice pass-through bath, what you might call a Jack and Jill. Access from the hallway and access from your bedroom. Nice shower, a little seat right there, and you got a little sunshade up there. Actually, skylight, if you don't want all that light coming in on a hot day like today, you know, you can close that off. It does have a light in here. This one's equipped with onboard washer and dryer. So you got both stackable washer and dryer. Nice sink with storage down below. They use a nice solid surface countertop. Like I mentioned, they don't go cheap on their motorhomes when they come from Tiffin. They do it right. Nice pull-out drawer, so you got lots of storage. Have a little access here for, I guess, a little storage in there. Maybe we'll throw some magazines or whatever in there. Good amount of storage. Bedroom area has two. We have two slide outs. So this is out, and that's out. So I've got this opens up really nice. King size bed. Tons of storage up above the bed. Goes back in there a long ways. They do put a separation in there too, so everything's not rolling around in there. Easier to get to stuff. It's fairly deep, so you might have. But you might want to put something in there that you can pull out pretty easily. A nice comfortable bed. Notice you do have nightstands on both sides. There's plug-ins right here. You got USB ports on both sides. And on that side over there, you do have controls, more of the spider multiplex controls. So you can access lighting right from the side of from your bed. You don't have to get out of bed, and you can get to your controls. Does come with a really nice entertainment center. This is a 3D Blu-ray player. This one does have a in-motion satellite on it already, and they do provide you with a dish network receiver also. Well, you might be thinking, well, I don't do dish network. Well, that's not a problem. We can change that out. You just have to get a different receiver. LG TVs, you got nice newer TVs, nice closet space, lots of drawers all the way around here. You got tons of drawers. Even has a little shelf here that you could use as maybe a little vanity or whatever the case may be. This all closes off too. Of course, you have sliding doors on both sides here. Great layout. Like I said, maybe you're in a coach now, you're just ready to move up and do a little more RVing. Give me a call. Have other questions, you can reach me at 541-510-1017 and just ask for Jim. Thanks.